Ladies and gentlemen, how you guys all doing today? I have the lovely and incomparable, the beard with the most, Mr. Brett Dub. Welcome.
Hello.
All right, let's go. Yeah. So, how's everything going for you? What's new? What's what it is? What it be like?
Things been going pretty well. I can't complain. Been actually at home babysitting now. Kind of stepped down from my job as manager. I was getting a new job. Things didn't work out the way they were exactly supposed to.
Right.
But still got the job just in time. So about 2-3 months, I'll get that job.
Okay.
Anyway, so in the process, I stepped down as manager. So I'm just part-time employee. And with that, I stay home and I'll take care of my niece who I live with. I stay with my mom, my sis. So
no, there's nothing wrong with that. And you're taking care of the niece. How is that?
Oh, yeah. It's great, man. I was super, super nervous. Like when the first time they asked me, like, hey, do you want to stay home with her? I was like,
Wait, how old is she?
Oh, she's 9 months now.
Oh, this a baby baby.
Oh, it's baby baby.
Oh, okay. Now I see where the nervousness kicks in. You're like,
yeah, I was really nervous. I was like, I don't know how to do that. Like, I just turned 29 and I didn't even know how to change a diaper until like last year. I was like, I don't want to go anywhere near her. I was like, that's y'all's business.
Right. But now you're all good, right?
Yeah, now we're all good. I know how to handle the cries and, you know, the whines and the needs and everything.
Nice.
We're all good.
So that's awesome. As a streamer, have you brought her in and showed everyone your niece?
Yeah. They've seen her a few times.
Oh, nice.
I bring her in now, but she's already out. She's napping.
So. No, you got to go wake the baby up now. You got to...
No, can't wake the baby.
All right, so we're going to dive right into, since we're already talking about this, how do you, as a streamer, we'll get more into, like, you as a streamer, but considering you have family, you have work, how do you balance streaming? How do you incorporate everything in the real world to your streaming?
So I won't lie, it is difficult, especially with the whole transition of my sister working. She needs a babysitter, and that interferes with my job. I wouldn't say interferes. I feel like interfere is the wrong word, but you know what I mean. So that,
yeah.
I took it upon myself to step in. That has nothing to do with my job. I took it upon myself to help out. So with that and helping out and then stepping down from work, I had to figure out my schedule and everything. Once I got my sister's schedule down of when I'm going to be babysitting, then I let my work know, like, hey, this is what I'm going to be doing. I need these days off, X amount of time, yada, yada. They said, okay, keep in mind, my job works around my time. That was part of the agreement when I got the job. So there's no like fuss or anything about like what I do or when I do it. But with that in mind, so with both of those schedules out, then I'm like, okay, now I'm going to work around with my stream. So that's how I get my stream time. How would you say, figured out?
Yeah, no, that's a good thing. Usually, sometimes streamers I've been doing this for a long time as far as streaming. And sometimes I've witnessed streamers struggling. And so I always like to know, because let's face it, there's the real world and then there's our online world. They come with different attributes to our health and our mental. So I always like to ask, how does one find the balance?
Yeah. Oh. Well, that kind of comes with just me as a person. I've always told myself, I even got it tattooed on me, like a little something I made up when I was 18. Just a little tattooed here. It means no matter where you are, you must forever stay strong and keep moving forward.
I like that.
That's just something I kept with me. So when I'm in a tough spot, whether it has something to do with streaming or whether it's work or my family, I just tell myself, you got to keep going. You got to keep going. If not for yourself, for the ones around you, for the ones that care about you.
I commend you for that. It
really keeps me going with in life and streaming and everything.
Is that your only tattoo?
No, I'm actually also a huge fan of Supernatural.
Okay. See you. Okay, fair enough. I want to know, how did you come up with your name as a streamer?
I caught myself saying Bretta a lot. And not a lot of people know this. So I'll go ahead and say it. I got it from Gibby on Apex. I love the way he said Bretta. Oh, Bretta. Yeah, Bretta. And it just, I kept saying it. I caught myself saying it without realizing I was saying it. And my friends realized it. They're like, yo, why do you keep saying Bretta? I was like, I am, huh? I keep saying that. I was like, you know what? I like it. My name was actually Bretta D Dub. My last name is Washington. So Dub isn't just.
Oh, okay.
It's a W. So it was Bretta D for DeAndre. DeAndre Washington. Bretta D Dub.
Nice.
I lost that account.
So how'd you lose the account?
You know, I don't know exactly what happened. I no longer had access to the email address. So I still had the account, right? I still had it.
You just can't access it.
I couldn't access the email address, and I was very uncomfortable with that. I did everything, and keep in mind, I'm secure. People usually they don't like the authentication or the double factor.
Yeah,
I love it.
Yeah, you gotta have it, bro. You gotta have it. You gotta have it.
Yeah. So for me not to have access, I was like, I don't like this. Trust me, I did everything I could to try to get it, but I couldn't. And since I felt like I didn't have the access, I was like, you know what? Let's just go ahead and start fresh. So I just deleted everything. Well, I had to start fresh on all of my games, my accounts, everything.
Right.
And so no longer Bretta D Dub. I just dropped it to Bretta Dub.
Okay. Now, let's talk about your mascot. How did you come up with your mascot? That
one was tricky. So I was Bretta Dub way before I even thought about, like, what's my mascot, my logo? So for those that do know me, I'm a huge Green Lantern fan. Huge fan.
Wait, did you say Green Lantern?
Yes, sir.
We'll get into that in a little bit. No, we're going to put a pin in that. We're coming back to that.
I figured. Yeah. All right, now don't ask me. I will say, don't ask me about the new stuff. I'm not gonna lie.
Don't worry, sir. Sir, I'm conducting the interview, sir. Don't worry about the questions at the moment. Let's just go with the mascot for now. We'll circle back to the problem. Go ahead.
Got you. Yeah. So, Green Lantern fan. So I knew I wanted to work around that, and at first I had my face around here somewhere. Here it is. This is my very first idea of my logo. I'm not sure if you can see it with the
glitter. Okay. We got a little Jamaican vibe to it.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
But then after that I was like, you know what? If I start branding and people are gonna be looking at other people's shirts and be like, why do you have a bearded dude on your shirt? So like, I don't think this would be actually pretty good for branding wise. So I was like, well, what are you like? You like Green Lantern? You like monkeys? I love monkeys. I do want a pet monkey, by the way. So future wife, heads up,
ladies.
Just letting you know.
Bring him monkey and you shall have his heart.
And I was like, you know what? There isn't a Green Lantern monkey. There was. Long time ago.
Right.
So I was like, you know what? Let me just make it my own thing. And because I didn't want to get sued, I was like, let's kind of just ease off the Green Lantern logo and
right. Just
put it on our own little thing right there.
No, I think it's a great thing. Do you have a name for your mascot?
You know what? I don't. I never thought about that. That is That's a good question.
Okay.
I never thought about having a name for my mascot. I figured it would just be Bread-A-Dub.
But I mean, if you're going to market and start branding, don't you think he should have a name?
I agree with you 100%. Like I said, it just never crossed my mind, but I'm definitely going to be thinking about that.
Well, I'm glad I created a whole new problem for you.
Yeah, there you go.
Let's.
I don't really have anything else to do. Now I do.
Now you do. All right. Well, you know what? While you're babysitting. So let me ask you this. How long have you been a streamer?
I think it's been 2 years now. Is it 2 years or three? I believe two. I'm gonna say 2 years.
All right, we're gonna go with two. It sounds a little unsure.
Final answer.
We're gonna go with 2 years. Okay. Now, for your streaming platform, what is it that you do? Are you a gamer, just chatting? Like, what is it that you do on your channel?
On my channel, I am a gamer. But I play all kinds of different games. I don't just stick to one thing.
Okay.
I'm pretty much a jack of all trades, master of none.
Okay. So basically any game you're up for, retro, current, like all that good stuff.
I usually been playing a lot of the current games, a lot of shooter games, but okay. I've been wanting to expand my horizon. I haven't always had a computer, so I'm actually new to the PC world. So looking into more games. I'm looking forward to actually getting back into solo games. I used to do that when I was a kid, and I don't do that anymore.
Okay, so most of the games you play are kind of like group games, like stuff like that. So yeah, like
multiplayer.
Okay, that's the word, multiplayer. And then first person shooters is kind of the majority of it. What game do you find yourself mostly playing? Kind of like you're like, man, I always play this. What's that game that you usually kind of find yourself playing?
If I am by myself and I'm like probably just waiting for some friends to get online, I would probably say Rocket League, honestly.
Okay. What is it about Rocket League that you like?
I don't know. I don't know if anyone can answer that question. When my friend first told me about the game, I said it was the stupidest thing I've ever heard in the world.
And it's got you hooked, though, but you play it.
It's got me hooked.
Okay.
Did you not? It took him 2 years. 2 years for me to finally say, dude, fine. I was at his house. We were playing the game. It was pissing me off. I was not having a good time, obviously, because I had no idea what to do. I had to do anything. I finally hit the ball. It went in the goal. I was like, yeah.
Oh, that's all it took for you to get hooked was...
I shut down real quick. I was like, nope.
Okay.
Nope. And then I was like, man, I'm not playing this no more. I think it was about a month later, I played a game, and I was like, oh, shit, I'm by myself. Damn it, I think I like this game. That was it.
And
off from there.
So Rocket League's like your ace in the hole. That's the game that... You're happy. That's like your happiest game to play. For as long as you've been playing these games, what's the worst game you ever played? That you're just like, why did they make this? This is trash.
I would have to say either. Oh no, what was that game? I had to give my money back. Everyone had to get their money back. Ended up not working. It was, oh my God, what was it called?
So they sold the broken game, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. How much did you have to pay?
I believe it was like $40.
That's a lot of money.
It wasn't crazy because, you know, games nowadays are like $80, but still 40s.
It's still a lot, man. It's
still $40. Yeah.
40's 40, bro.
Yeah, 40's 40.
And so the game was just broken and everybody was like, this is...
Yeah, so it was this kind of open world zombie shooter game. You can load in there with your friends. You basically go in there and loot and kill zombies, and you can kill other survivors. And then you extract. Well, going to play the game, I'm like, where the f*** are the zombies? You would run into like two zombies, maybe. And then you might see other characters, Maybe.
Oh, wow. That sucks, dude.
Yeah, and there were a lot of mechanics that just weren't working out. And it honestly could have been a really good game. It could have. It had a lot of potential, but it didn't work out. And I forgot why they said why. I guess they just didn't have what they needed to keep going, unfortunately. Another one was Redfall. That's the first one I was going to say.
Redfall.
Yeah, that was the vampire one. I don't know if you've seen that one. Kind of the same thing, kind of open world, but you go in there and you're with your buddies and you're killing vampires and things.
Right.
Just so many bugs. It was so
bad. It's horrible. No, I can honestly say I am not a gamer at all to the extent of like what you do and a few other people I know. I just talk.
Yeah, I remember you saying that before.
Yeah. Yeah. And first person shooter games for me with PTSD is a little difficult to kind of navigate or sit and watch. So. You know, but it's not about me right now. It's about you, sir. I see how you try to pivot. Okay, I see.
No, I'm not trying anything. I mean, I do like to get to know people, but
maybe you can interview me someday in the future, my good sir.
There we go.
So let me ask you this. For your community, do you have a name for your community?
I thought about it, but then I don't want anyone getting any wrong ideas or anything, because the original idea was calling everyone Bretta.
All right.
Like, no, non-binary, just, hey, what up, Bretta?
You know, just what up, Bretta?
Dude. Like, saying dude. Like, chick's a dude, guy's a dude.
We're all dudes.
We're all dudes.
Right.
but then I was like, you know, people might get upset. So I'm giving them the option of saying sister. Then I was like, well, I'm probably going to have people that are like, oh, I don't want to be Bretta or sister. I'm like, okay.
I had
an argument with myself about it.
So you're over here debating yourself of things that's never going to happen.
And I was just like, all right, not happening. Okay. Not happening. You people can't make up your minds. Not happening.
Okay. What's the longest you've ever streamed?
Actually, it was just this previous stream for 50 hours.
I know.
So yeah,
I know. I popped in. You was doing your thing. Yeah. By the way, happy birthday!
Thank you.
Because I know what that was about. We celebrated your birthday on my channel. You never showed up. Whereas, like, we're gonna celebrate his birthday anyway.
I'm so sorry.
You don't remember that thing I had you type in on my channel, and then we put you on the thing that scrolls on top and your birthday shows up all the time.
Oh my god.
So many people pointed it out. They're like, it's his birthday. I'm like, he's probably doing birthday shit. And I'm just like, we'll just celebrate, and we did the little dance and we had cake and we played birthday songs. Oh, and
I missed it all.
No, but you were busy doing other things like a 50-hour stream. So how did that turn out?
I still could have came by, but it was good. I learned my lesson.
What lesson would that be?
Let's not start off with 24 hours.
You know, like I'm known for my 24 hours, and I'm known for, I rarely do a 48. I got beat recently from another streamer, and I just have to beat her time. She did a 72.
A 72?
I need to beat it. So, you know, so what is the lesson, like, what's the lesson that you learned from doing an extended stream such as that to where you're like, you know, I may do it in the future and I may not, don't hold your breath. So what was it about it that kind of gave you this sort of thought process on extended streams?
So honestly, I was perfectly fine with it, with everything. I was actually supposed to go another, I believe, 35 hours or so. I was supposed to keep going, but I wasn't expecting to blow up so much. And from that, I had to say, hey guys, I'm terribly sorry, but in about 10 hours, we're going to have to cut the stream. I have to work the next day. I can't call off work again because I called off work for this.
Oh.
I can't call off another day.
Right.
I gotta go to work. I'm sorry. So to make up for it, I'm probably just going to just take those hours and put it onto another stream, or I'm going to figure something out to give back to the people. for what I can.
So you would say scheduling conflicts for something like that?
Yeah, definitely scheduling. It was a last minute thing. I just thought about it like the day before. I was like, let me just do a subathon for my birthday. I didn't post anything until I think like a few hours before it. It was not planned at all. I did learn my lesson. All right, let's not start off with 24 hours. Let's start off with a like good solid 5 to 10, and then we'll go from there.
We'll go from there if it's nice. We'll okay. Lesson learned. Okay. As a streamer of you doing it for the past 2 years, what has been the best moment in your streaming career that you can remember to this date? Like that moment.
The best moment, I would honestly have to say, God, that's really hard.
And it could be anything current to when you first started.
Favorite moment would have to be between my birthday stream and probably the stream before that, when I had someone brand new that felt terribly bad for me for not knowing how to play the game and just gifted 20 subs.
No,
because I was like, oh god, I was like, nothing's working. We couldn't join each other. Nothing was happening. And then when we did start the game, they were way higher level than I was. So it was just hell. And he was just like, oh god, no. He's like, this is not the game. So he just, I don't know. That was a good one.
That's nice.
But I would have to say my birthday stream has got to be the best, just because I had so many people come in there and just show so much love and just so much support, not just to me, but just giving out subs to the community. Like it's so amazing.
I witnessed how happy you were, man. Again, when I show up, I normally don't say anything. I just want to observe.
Yeah, no, I don't know what to say. I don't expect it. I'm just here just to have fun and just to show people, you know. No matter how tough things get, just gotta try your best and stay positive and keep going, and nice. You can do it.
What's the worst moment you've ever had? And this could be anything ever while live that you're just like, you were very it got to you, and it could be anything anything. It could be anything. You were live, and this happened, and it was like the worst.
Oh, it was definitely my internet being buggy. I was having like the worst difficulty just trying to stay connected to my stream. And this is back when I was streaming off my laptop and my Xbox. I could not get the connection for like a good solid 2 hours. And once I finally got the connection, it was barely stable, but it was there. And then we were just losing. And oh my God, I was like, I'm sorry, guys. I got in for the night.
It does get to you when technical issues happen all the time.
Yeah.
I do want to ask you a question about your backdrop and everything.
Mm-hmm.
Could you explain, like, how you got your aesthetics the way it looks, and the whole thing? Like,
yeah,
I like it.
So, thank you. I appreciate that. So actually a lot is brand new. I would grab my camera and kind of show you around, but it's all wired in. It's stuck there. It ain't moving. But I got a lot of brand new things. Got my double monitor with my new desk set up, and I wanted to get my room looking, you know, nice for my stream. So I thought about, well, what could I have? I was like, first of all, let's grow up a little bit. I had a bed since I was a kid. It was a bunk bed, but we took the top part down, obviously. So it was just the bottom part is old wooden bed. Nothing wrong with it at all. It looks perfectly fine.
Right.
But I wanted something that I want, that I bought for me, that I like. So I bought me a bed that has a glowing light around it.
Hey, no, that's
these lights are actually a part of the bed. They're not a part of these lights.
Really?
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Apparently I can plug up music to it and the music will go with it.
So that's the whole headboard.
Yeah, that's the whole headboard.
That's actually pretty cool.
Yeah, it's got 4 trays on the sides too that I can roll out on the bottom of the bed. So it's got some extra cubby in there.
Hey.
Got me a new dresser. You can't really see because it's dark as hell.
No.
Black dresser. And then with the panels, those were actually a gift present for me slash the family, because I get so loud sometimes. I used to do a lot of horror streams. So I play scary games.
And you would scream.
Yeah, because keep in mind, I love horror movies, all that stuff. And no problem. Scary games, whole new world to me.
Really?
World. Yeah, so I was not ready for what was happening. My family wasn't ready for what was happening. So we're like, you know what? Let's get some panels.
And do those panels work very well?
They do. She did say that they have been working. Oh, sorry, I'm like trying to think and talk at the same time. she's saying that it's not as noisy, but I'm still loud. So it all comes down to the person. But she does say it's working. Plus, I have a whole another section right here that I haven't put in yet.
Right.
I need to do that.
Probably. Is she your biggest supporter as a streamer?
For sure. For sure. She's always asked me, like, how's the stream going? Like, how's everything doing? Like, she's always asked me about how it is.
Now, this lady, now, is she your mom?
Yeah.
Because we never established in this interview who she is.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah, sorry. It's my mom.
Nice. Yeah, if your mom was watching this. Okay, so hold on. So your mom's watching this.
She better.
Hold on now. What you going to get yourself in trouble next thing you know your panels are missing. I'm going to give you the floor for a minute. If there's anything you'd like to say to her as a streamer, take it away.
Well, mom, I got to say, just thank you so much for supporting me and everything that I'm doing. I mean, if it wasn't for you supporting me, I don't even know if I could keep going. You tolerate with my loudness and my craziness, and I don't know who else would other than you. So thank you so much. I love you.
Nice. Oh. So that's in the real world of support. Let's talk about your online support, your community.
Mm-hmm.
How good are they to you? And give me some honorable mentions. And if you got any mods, and what is it about your community that just makes it that much better as a streamer?
Well, I gotta say, first, it's hard to single anyone out. Just because simply I love my community, honestly. And that's not me trying to just bullshit or, you know, just trying to hype anyone up. This is the truth. I love my community. I try to build up positivity, and that's what they do. They build up positivity, you know, whether it's towards me or towards each other. Even whenever we have like new people coming in and they're just gifting out subs, it's not for me. Like, maybe I'm taking a part of the profit, but that's not for me. It's right. For them. And we're welcoming them into the community to say, hey, whatever's going on, man, we're here for you. We're just here to have a good time, hang out, meet some new people, play some new games, and, you know, just take over the world in positivity.
Nice. Fair enough. All right. So how long have you been on Twitch just as a person in general? How long have you been on the Twitch platform?
Oh, just about as long as I've been streaming.
So this is fairly recent then.
Yeah.
So what got you into Twitch? So how did you fall into... Okay, let's see if we can do this different. Okay, let's see if we can break this down.
I think I know what question you're going for. Like what got me attracted to Twitch?
Yeah, let's go with that. Let's go with what got you attracted to Twitch, and then we'll follow it up with what made you get in front of the camera.
I would have to say that's my friend Clay. He's also a streamer, if you want to check him out. The Mr. Claybo, my best friend. Whenever we met and we hung out, he was watching a fellow streamer, and I kind of knew what Twitch was, but I never really looked into it. I didn't really know much, like, at all. All I knew is that gamers play games. That's all I knew.
Right.
I didn't know about the rules, the regulate. Like, I didn't know anything. So I kind of just watched stuff with his buddy, and he was talking about wanting to stream, and I was like, that would be fun. That might be actually fun to do. And what made me really decide to actually start streaming was going, well, play video games every day. kind of funny. Kind of. Sometimes. You and your friends have a lot of fun. You're not that good, but yeah, you try. And if I can do this, then I think anyone else can. You know, it's, and I know I keep saying it, I sound like a broken record, but it's all about staying positive, you know? My whole goal is to show, or not to show, I'm sorry. My whole goal is to make at least one person's day better. That's where it all started from. I simply just wanted to make at least one person's day better. I believe if we could do that, then we can slowly help the world become a better place.
I like that.
I mean, people dog on people about watching other people, but who cares? It brings them happiness, you know? Maybe they hear some advice that they like. Maybe they found a tip in a game that they didn't know, and now they're playing better. You never know.
You never know. All right, well, considering I like this positive attitude, if we can go back in time and you met yourself right at the beginning of your streaming career, what are some things you would tell yourself that you wish you would have known now that you could have applied then?
Things that I wish I would have known now. Well, obviously how to do overlays and everything. That would have been super helpful from the start.
Right. That is a part of our job.
If I could go back and tell myself anything. Don't overthink it. If no one's there, who cares? You're having a good time. That's the whole point. Having a good time. Whether one person's there or a million people are there, just have a good time.
Okay. So within the couple of years of you being on Twitch, of course, you've watched other people and you've joined other communities without any names. What are some of the best things you've seen other streamers do that you have either included in your stream or you're just like, I enjoy what they do. I like to be I'm glad I'm here.
I would have to say it was difficult, but fitting a hot tub and getting in a bikini was not easy.
Okay.
No, I'm just kidding.
No, if that's what it is. No, I totally get it. I get it.
No, but I would say there are, when it came to Twitch, like I said, I didn't know anything. I thought it was just gaming. So when I found out that it was just more than that, I was like, oh, this is actually really cool. And I can't believe, or no, I'm sorry, not believe. I can't remember who it was, but they rated out to a streamer who does talks. And I was, for the first time, like, I actually enjoy this. This is nice. It was the first time where I'm not watching someone playing video games that's doing something else. And it's been stuck with me since. Still watch them to this day.
Oh, nice. Now we're going to go on the opposite end of this. Without dropping any names, what are some of the worst things you've seen? You're like, I got to get out of here. And then either you've unfollowed them or you're just like, I could never go back to that. What would have been some things that you may have seen out there? They just kind of goes, that's not my vibe. You're like, that's disgusting.
I don't remember their name, but so I guess that's fortunate. I truly don't remember their name, but it's when I was new to Twitch. I was learning about the do's and don'ts. I didn't know. Don't talk about your stream and other people's streams.
They call it leeching. You're not supposed to really do that. Yeah.
Or sniping. So what I had kind of done, like I didn't, it's not what I did. It's what they said. And I was like, okay. So let me just get to it. Beating around the bush. Whenever I had joined her stream, she was really cool, really friendly, really nice. I would go back in her streams, you know, this is going on for like a week or so. And then she was like, hey, what are you up to today? What do you have planned? And I was like, oh, I don't know. I was thinking about going live later. I don't know. And she's like, oh, great. We got another sniper.
Awesome. Yeah, that's, and I was like, that's horrible. Yeah. You asked. You, I get it.
Oh, like, my bad.
I think that was shitty on her part because she asked you.
that. I was like, you ass, I'm sorry.
Oh man, I'm sorry you went through that.
I'm like, hey, I'm going live at this time. You should come check me out. I was just like, I'm thinking about streaming later.
And she called you a sniper. Oh man. She
called me a sniper. And I was like, okay, unfollow.
Yeah, that's pretty toxic.
It would have been one thing if she was like, hey, we don't want any stream sniping in here. Yada. Okay. Got it. I'd have been like, oh, okay, that's stream sniping. My bad. But it's her just jumped the gun and be like, oh, stream sniper, great, awesome, love to see you. And I'm like, yo, with the hostility.
Yeah. No, you're a nice guy. I don't, like, you know what? She missed out on checking you out, bro. You're a nice guy.
She missed out. Thank you so much. I appreciate that.
Yeah. Let me ask you this question here. Growing up, remember those cards I had asked you to pick a certain number? We're going to kind of incorporate these in here.
All right.
And you picked 20.
I did.
So growing up, did you have someone that influenced you or that you can remember growing up that you will always remember?
Someone that influenced me.
Mm-hmm. Or coached you, whatever way. Inspired you that you can always recall the memory and be like, yeah.
Well, I would probably have to say my parents, honestly. I mean, they've been divorced my whole life, but they've been a part of my whole life.
Okay.
Even though they haven't been together, they have to me. If that makes sense.
No, it totally makes sense. I myself comes from homes like that. And my story would be a little different, but you are a very lucky man that they were able to still do their job and take care of you. And it's really nice that you said 20. How old are you now?
I just turned 29.
Yeah. And for you to still say something positive, you know what I mean? That says a lot on their parenting skills. If you can still sit here damn near 30 and still say something positive about your parents, that means they did a great job, man.
We definitely had our rough patches, but I'd say all in all, we're all good.
Okay. All good.
You know, growing up with dad, it was more of what not to do and control. And then being at mom's was do whatever and learn.
Right.
So it's kind of the yin and yang of what I had growing up.
Okay. What do you see yourself in 5 years as a streamer? Like, what are you going to still be playing games? Are you going to switch it up? What are some of your goals in 5 years as a streamer?
I actually do have a plan of what I want to do. The issue comes down to who I have in what I want to do, because I had this whole idea. And of course, I don't think it's an original idea, obviously, but I just wanted to have, you know, me and a group of guys, and we play games, we make animations, we do in-live stuff. Maybe one guy likes cars, maybe another guy likes hiking, or maybe one chick, maybe she just loves motorsports. I don't know.
Right. Like a variety. A
variety pack of friends, yeah. I'm not saying I want friends that do those specific things. Like, I mean, we don't have to do all that, but I really wanted to do, like, gaming, animations, and live-action skits. I've always wanted to do skits. I used to want to be an actor. Like, it was
what I always
wanted to do growing
up. I'm going to be rooting for you and looking forward to all that.
Well, we'll hope so.
10 years ago, best describe yourself.
10 years ago, let's see, 19. Love drunk.
Love drunk. Okay. Tell me all about that.
I was always into the ladies, I guess you could say. But more so that I was more into the idea of, well, love. And I was young. I wasn't trying to explore and have fun. I was looking for the one.
You wanted substance.
Yeah, and they weren't that, and then which fell into drinking and smoking and all that not good stuff. But we recovered.
We recovered. We're good now. I don't need
any of it.
If you had to pick one streaming path, all right, one streaming path, there's so many different categories in. Yeah. And you had to pick one thing. It has to be one thing. What would it be? And you'd be stuck with it. So what would it be as a streamer?
Like what category would I only stream?
Well, yeah, but you only get to do one thing, like art, design. Like if you could, if you had the talent, it's you only can do one thing. If it's a particular game, it has to be one thing.
It has to be a particular game.
It could be anything, but it has to be one.
That is a tough one. If I could only do one thing. Do I have to know how to do it now?
Yeah, no. This is just a hypothetical. You have the talent for it.
To just be like, play the guitar.
Yeah, and you would stream guitar playing. That would be it. But that's the whole thing. So you have the talent, you have the resources, but you can only do one thing as a streamer, just one, and that's what you are only going to be known for. What would it be?
Stopping crime.
What is that?
As a superhero, I can do whatever, right?
Okay, all right.
Is that a little too far out?
No. I want to know. Like, you're gonna be streaming this. Like, okay, what is?
Yeah, she's got it like live on the chest. She's kind of just flying around.
There's nothing wrong with that. Again, we're still gonna come back to that. We're still gonna come back to that one issue I'm gonna be picking with you. We're gonna save that for last about this Green Lantern issue.
Oh,
that's okay. All right. So, okay, we're going to kind of fast forward a little bit here. All right. Sure. You've made it as a streamer. You're out here doing it. And money is no object. What is it that you would give back to your community, your streaming community? If you had the money to, you can give back to them. What would be the one thing that you would do for them out of the kindness of your heart?
If not, give back their money, because I'm not in this for the money. I don't know. I would say, off the top of my head, just hold an event for everyone. I don't know, maybe like a festival, like a little music festival.
Oh, okay.
I want to come together, just meet each other, mingle, have fun, get to know each other, chat it up. And who knows, you know, connections. People can either find their career, or people could find their loved one at this event. You never know.
Hey, okay. Oh, there you are. You're love sniping at your own event.
it's creeping back.
Nice. So let's kind of focus on this love thing, because it's a good topic. What would be your ideal proposal to your partner? Again, where these are all hypotheticals, there's no restrictions. What would be
that?
Yes, you know what I mean? Like, I don't want to be like, well, you're working here and you're down to your last dollar. No. Let's be creative. If you had the funds, what would be that ideal marriage proposal?
See, that is a really tough question, simply because it all comes down to the woman. How did I meet her? Where did we meet? What is she like? What does she love?
Okay. You met her at McDonald's as a customer. You were just there grabbing some food.
All right. So I'm loving it.
Mm-hmm. You find out she works for Hollywood as a screenwriter and she's a quadriplegic. Go.
Shit. Damn, that was a tough one. Okay.
Yeah, I gave it to you to try to figure it out, but you want me to do it.
She works for Hollywood?
Yeah, so what would be your ideal proposal? And don't be like, oh, stairs. And I'm like, she can't climb stairs.
Money's no object.
Of course. This is just a nice, well about I can do it question.
I'm building her a ramp all the way up to Hollywood sign.
That's very nice. So
and then come down on a helicopter.
Okay.
No, that's too much.
keep going. So we got a ramp. So while you're taking the helicopter up there, she's using the ramp.
She's got the ramp.
Okay, she's keeping her independence. She's
gonna fly by it too and give a little.
Hey, because you're giving her independence. Okay. Yeah. You respect. Okay.
What she wants. Gotta give a woman what she wants.
I would be there for that too. I'd be like, my happy dude, wife, happy life. Brother is about to propose like no other. No, that's very sweet. Okay. All right.
But in all honesty, I would try to go above and beyond and just really try to hit home, probably with something that she wouldn't even think about that I remembered, you know?
Yeah.
Or maybe somewhere she always wanted to go.
Okay. Like that. Growing up, what was that one thing you wanted to be when you grew up? When you grew up?
An actor.
You wanted to be an actor. That thing was still as a kid till now, an actor. And then you're going to marry a lady who works in Hollywood.
Tomorrow. Let's go. Let's do it.
Fair enough. In high school, did you play any sports or any academics or anything in high school that people may not know about you? I kind of think sports is a little vague. I mean, just anything extra. Anything anyone doesn't know about you?
So I tried sports. Tried doing track. I ended up quitting.
Why?
I learned that my school is about favoritism.
I heard that.
I didn't believe it. Keep in mind, I wasn't from this district. I moved district. So my elementary and middle school, I was in one district. And then high school, freshman year, I went to a new district. So this is all brand new. Yeah, I was doing track. I was doing the 100 dash. And I noticed that I wasn't going to any of the track meets. I had no idea why. I was faster than some of the other guys that were going. So why wasn't I going?
Right.
And I kept asking coach about it. And he's like, oh, we got you in the next meet. I wasn't in the next meet. I asked him about it again. He said, we got you in the next one. I wasn't in the next one. For the third time, I was like, coach, I haven't been going to any of the meets. Am I going to go to any of them? He's like, yeah, we got you on the list for this one. Sure enough, I was. Awesome. I was super excited, man. I was like, finally, now I get to show them some real speed.
Right?
Oh, I was super pumped. We get up to the line, or they call out our names. We get up to the line. I'm like, why am I racing two of my guys from my school? So to put me in and to put everyone in, they ended up just throwing everyone into the track meet.
Hey, oh, wow.
You want to do the 100 dash? Sure, you can do it.
So instead of putting you on, they just put you in.
They just put me in. And I had to race against two other guys from my same school.
Oh, man.
Like, this is so stupid.
That's crazy.
Okay, after that, I quit. Oh, no, I'm sorry. It was after my cleats went missing and were in someone's locker, and the school said that they couldn't do anything about it because I couldn't prove that they were mine. I was like, oh, yeah, y'all got me. Stop.
Yeah, that sounds like some problematic shit right there, buddy.
After that, I was like, you know what? Fuck this school. And I didn't have anything else to do with it. But my mood got better. It went from fuck this school to just do your own thing. Go your own path. Do what you got to do. Just keep going.
Favorite curse word?
Probably fat.
Okay.
I don't know.
You got to pick one. Come on now. These questions can't be that hard for you.
I say a lot of different things. Like, I always say, like, what the shit? Like, I don't know.
All right, fine. We'll gloss over that one. Fine.
That's a tough one.
Tell me your first date you ever had.
First word was fuck.
Okay, so we'll go with fuck then. First that's fine. Fuck. What was your first date you ever had?
My first date?
Mm-hmm. Oh, do you remember it?
Oh, God. I don't think I do.
That's fine. I'm sure she isn't going to watch. It's fine. It's fine, bro.
Probably not.
If you could collab with any streamer, who would it be?
I already am.
With yourself?
No. With you see?
Nah, you leave me out of this. This is about you. Look, for someone gaming.
And I'll be honest with you, this is something else I need to expand my horizons in.
Oh, so no, I mean,
I don't really know a lot of people.
Hey, that's okay. Hey, I'll tell you what, in 5 years when you're famous, I'll ask that question again. I'll double back.
There we go.
Give me two things off your bucket list that you want to cross off, and then give me one thing on your bucket list that you already crossed off.
Okay. Skydiving.
Okay.
For sure. What else do I want to do? Star in a hit movie.
Okay.
I never thought about that one. I like that one. Actually be a part of, I don't know how you would say it. I was in a kind of skit commercial kind of.
Okay.
So
you had like, some airtime.
Kinda. It was like for these comedians and their opening skit. It was literally just like me and him, and we were just like taking drinks at a bar. Like that was it.
Hey, like hey, but at least, hey, at least you were able to do it. Not a people aren't going to be out there doing it.
It was like watered down, just something. It was so gross.
Hey, that's awesome.
I wasn't 21. They couldn't give me a real drink, so.
So you had to have that. You had to have the gross.
Yeah, we were at a bar drinking, and I got the watered down crap.
In your room right now, what is your most prized possession and why?
My most prized possession. Wow. That is tough. I love all my stuff. All my stuff are gifts.
What's the most memorable gift that you got then? Let's go with that. What's like the one thing when you look at it, it just, you know what I mean? Like it just does something for you.
Oh, y'all can't see it. Hold
on. No. You don't. No. Just describe it.
It's a sombrero.
Okay.
Yeah. Just off the top of my head, I'm gonna look at it.
So what's this? Yeah, what's that about?
Yeah, I got that from Mexico. It's actually from Mexico. Whenever my dad got married to his ex-fiance.
That's fair, and you just kept the hat because you're just like, I love Mexico.
From Mexico, I'm not gonna throw that away. That's authentic, man.
That's authentic shit right there. As a streamer, what's your most proudest moment?
As a streamer, proudest moment.
Yeah.
For me, my proudest moment. I don't know, man. That's tough. I mean, I have a lot of proud moments. Like whenever we hit our following goal, like that's a proud moment. Not because like I'm getting more popular, but that's because more people are here in the community that are going to get to interact with each other. So that's awesome.
Yeah.
Like that's a really awesome moment. Proud moment. Let's see what else. Probably finally being able to do something that I can't do in a game, whether it's beating a level or pulling off a trick shot that I can never do.
All right.
I would say as proud moments, there's a lot of those that happen. There's a lot.
They just got to come to your stream to see this, huh?
You just got to
show up.
You just got to be there. You just got to be there.
Favorite horror movie, horror monster, and worst horror movie ever or subgenre?
Oh, I knew this was coming and I just wasn't ready for it. My favorite probably has to be Freddy Krueger.
Oh, yes.
Love
that guy.
One, because it terrifies my dad.
Wait, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, what? Yeah. Freddy Krueger, like, bothers your father?
Was a fireman, by the way, or was.
Wait, I'm sorry. Freddy Krueger.
I'm not saying he still terrifies
him. But back then, you can remember it bothered him.
Back then, yeah, Freddy, he was not a fan. Not a fan.
Freddy Krueger's. Yeah,
it's so funny. I was like, "You're a firefighter, dude."
I'm sorry. I don't need to laugh, but it's fucking great. All right, so Freddy Krueger, the Nightmare on Elm Street series, you definitely love that. Worst franchise or worst horror movie you ever saw in your dislike? Why or whatever Ginger that genre Dead. Is.
Ginger Dead Man.
Ginger Dead Man?
Yeah. It's the it's a killer gingerbread man.
Stop. It was that bad, huh?
Need I say more?
No, all right.
I mean, if you can look into it. There's a famous actor that voices the character. I can't.
Wait, it has a voice?
Yo, it moves.
Oh, Lord.
I mean, it's awful, but it moves.
My worst subgenre is occult or ghost movies. I just don't like them because they're like predictable. And I don't like.
Yeah.
If it's going to be a horror movie or a scary movie, give me the element of surprise. That's what makes it horrible.
Right.
And mine would be the Saw series. And the reason being I like those is because you can literally do that to someone. So there's like realism in it. It can
possibly happen.
Yeah. And so I'm just like, yeah, that's kind of messed up.
Leprechaun, you better watch out.
Love Leprechaun. Matter of fact, all 80s horror movies, always good stuff. I mean, we can go look. This interview will end up turning into a whole.
We're gonna go somewhere else.
Yeah, we're gonna go somewhere else. No, this is about you. See, I see what you're doing. You deflect. Now let's get down to the real meat of this conversation about you.
Mm-hmm.
What drives you to put all this together, from the real world to the online world? What is that driving force that makes you get up and just literally just keep going? I understand the tattoo. I understand the significance of family, and that's online and offline.
Mm-hmm.
But at the core of who you are, what is it that drives you to keep doing it?
That's an easy one for me. It's life. And with that, I know. Well, I guess I don't know. That's a whole nother spiritual thing. I'm not going to get into that. But as of this life that I know of, I'm only going to get this one chance, and I don't want to spend it being upset or sad. I want to enjoy it. And that's what I want for everyone else too. I want them to enjoy life. And that's why I do what I do. That's why I stay as positive as I do, even when I don't want to be. I know I have to, because if not for myself, I have to do it for the others. And it's honestly, still to this day, why I'm still alive is because of keeping that mindset.
Nice. All right. Before I'm still going to get you for what you said earlier, because I'm going to hang that to the end. I'm going to give you the floor right now to just leave a message to your community. Because I'm sure they're going to see this in the future. And for anyone new, take it away. What would you like to say to your community?
What up, all my brothers and sisters? thank you guys so much. I can never, ever say thank you enough. You guys are so supportive, so awesome, always looking out for me and each other. Even when I'm not in my best moods, you guys are still there for me, and I appreciate that. And I'm glad you're all there for each other. For everyone that may be seeing this in the future, I hope we're still rocking it, baby. And I hope you guys are having a good life. And thank y'all so much.
Fair enough. All right. Let's get down to the meat of it.
All right.
So tell me in your best word, and you better be truthful of this, what is it about the Green Lantern that resonates with you? Why the Green Lantern out of all the superheroes in the world and supervillains across all sorts of, you know, medium? What is it about the Green Lantern in general,
mm-hmm,
that draws you to this character?
Being able to control your emotions no matter what the state is.
Okay.
Having the willpower to keep going, whether you have fear or you have love overcoming you, whatever is happening, you have to keep the willpower.
When did you find out the Green Lantern would be someone you can relate to?
In high school, when I no longer wanted to go on, I found the Green Lantern. I was just looking through superheroes, like Spider-Man was always my favorite. So there's that too. Spider-Man is my second favorite. But I always ask myself, like, who, like, I ask myself the same question, like, who do I relate to? And I found the Green Lantern, and I found just so much about it, and I just really drove to me. And keeping the mindset of staying strong and keeping that willpower and keeping all the negative thoughts out is what helped me keep going in life. So,
nice.
Yeah, I would say that's, there's more to it than just, oh, he's cool, he's got a ring that can do shit.
I think the concept of Green Lantern is a pretty good one.
Yeah.
I'm just glad that they...
Without the superpower, it was just the concept itself. I was like, yeah.
That's you all day. Yeah, okay.
I dig that.
Nice. Now, out of all the Green Lanterns, who's your favorite?
John Stewart. Second favorite. It's... Yeah, dang it.
I'm going to call DC and be like...
I know. I kept wanting to say Alan Scott, but it's Hal Jordan.
Hal Jordan. That's fair.
Yeah, yeah, the main Green Lantern. A lot of people are like, oh, of course it is. Well, I mean, he's kind of fucking powerful, so...
Very and nice.
Like I said, I don't know about what's going on in today's comics. I fell off. I really got to get back into it. There's new Green Lanterns that I don't even know the backstories of. But as far as I knew, Hal Jordan was the most powerful. It wasn't like just about the power, like what he could do. It's also about who he was.
Yeah.
And why he did the things that he did. And that's why he was always my favorite.
Okay. All right. No, there's nothing wrong with that. I just really wanted to know. I mean, we'll maybe in down the line, we'll have a comic book chit chat, but I'm not going to do that to you because it's not necessary. It's not about me. Now, we're at the end of...
I love it.
Yeah. Look, I'll tell you what. You let me know whenever you're ready and... you just tell me and then we're going to go in I'm like the worst person to do this with because I'll make you second think some shit. But all right, if this the smoke you want, sir, then I shall be your Sinestro to your Green Lantern. All right.
Gotcha. I'm looking forward to it.
Absolutely. Now, tell everyone where they can find you. I'm going to link everything below the video and then we're going to get you out of here. I want to say thank you.
All right, you guys can check me out on Twitch at BrettaDub, or a lot of my platforms are all Bretta_DubTTV. That's BRUDA_DUBTTV. You can find me on Twitch, Instagram, TikTok, YouTube. Not a lot on there, but I'm working on that. Just keep looking out for me. You'll see more of me.
Yep. Hold him to him, folks. In 5 years, he better be doing something. I'm gonna pull receipts. I'm like, so it's 5 years.
It's about that time.
I appreciate you guys watching and hanging out with us. And until next time, guys, cheers. You can say bye now if you like.
Bye.